में मैं काउंसिल जनरल डॉक्टर स्वाति कुलकर्णी और इनके सहयोगियों को धन्यवाद देना चाहूंगा कि इन्होंने ये कार्यक्रम प्रस्तुत करके आप सभी को मिलने का मुझे मौका दिया है। आपको जैसे आपको पता होगा मैं यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स अमेरिका में मेरे आए हुए 3 हफ्ते हुए, मैंने 11 जनवरी को प्रेसिडेंट डोनाल्ड ट्रंप से मुलाकात हुई, मेरे लेटर्स ऑफ क्रेडेंशियल अपॉइंटमेंट लेटर्स मैंने प्रस्तुत किया और उस टाइम से कुछ वाशिंगटन में ही ज़्यादातर मेरे फोकस रहा। पर जब मैं हमारे जितने भी 5 कॉन्सल जनरल्स हैं उनसे मेरी मुलाकात हुई वाशिंगटन में, तो मैंने कहा कि मुझे आपके इलाके में आके एक दिन ज़रूर बिताना है और मुझे ये कह के खुशी हो रही है आपको बताने की कि पहला रिस्पांस अटलांटा से आया है।
डॉक्टर को करने का कोई मुकाबला भी नहीं है,
शिकागो में भी नारी शक्ति है
मगर इनका मुकाबला नहीं है।
So it is a very great pleasure for me to be here and to be having the opportunity to interact with representatives of our community, not only in Atlanta and in Georgia, but also some of the neighboring states of southeastern United States. Taking stock of our relationship, I would say that our relations with the USA today have never been better. We have made a huge amount of progress in the last few years and today we are cooperating on all fronts. We are two countries that have recognized that we have shared values and principles, that we are vibrant democracies and that we are sharing those ideas in partnerships, not just on the bilateral front but regionally and globally. Our perception in the United States has changed significantly, the perception of India. One of the reasons, of course, is the growth of India economically. But another reason, which I have never hesitated to say, is the success of the Indian community in the USA.
Yes.
The Indian community in USA has shown tremendous spirit, entrepreneurial spirit, has shown that they are top professionals, top people in the high technology sector, doctors, engineers, and in every field that they are represented in. Today we have a 4 million strong Indian community, both the US citizens and Indian citizens. The community is a source of great strength for us. We do understand that you have a stake in improving relations between India and USA, your country of origin and your country of citizenship, in the case of many of you. We have a similar stake and we are working together with you. You are our partners, stakeholders, interlocutors in strengthening relations between India and the United States. We are having an outreach to Congress. There are many new congressmen, new senators. We are seeking the help of the Indian community in leveraging your very, very close association, many of these elected representatives of yours. I would like to thank all of you for supporting that effort through our Consul General here. The southeastern part of USA is a very important focus point. Although this is the last of our consulates established in 2011, but not the least, I have to say, because this area is a very important area for us. We have about 80 companies from India that have invested $8 billion in the area. We have some 120,000 in Georgia, right?
Yes.
Community of 120,000 here, and many more in the neighboring states. Clearly, there is scope to take that relationship exponentially forward with your support. The states of Mississippi and Florida is also establishing offices, commercial offices in India. I met Governor Kemp today on behalf of the Consul General. I also proposed to him that Georgia should also set up an office in India. We should also look to utilizing Atlanta's status as an international aviation hub to establish direct flights between Atlanta and India.
Delhi
or Mumbai?
And Mumbai.
Mumbai.
think Delta is going to fly.
Has to happen somewhere.
Delta is flying.
What about South India?
What is important is that we are connected directly with this part of the country. There are plans to upgrade the port of Savannah significantly. I'm told that would also increase capacity in terms of the trade between India and USA. Incidentally, trade has gone up not in small quantities, but gone up significantly. We are today at $140 billion of bilateral trade. India is buying much more for the United States today. We have reduced the trade deficit, which is in favor of India, from $26 billion 2 years ago to $19 billion today. We are buying about $5 billion of oil and gas. We are buying $18 billion of defense equipment. We have placed orders for 300 civilian aircraft worth $40 billion. I'm also happy to say that that Indian students who are studying, some of our best students are studying in the United States. We saw some from Georgia Tech this afternoon. 227,000 Indian students currently study in the United States, and they contribute $6.5 billion to the American economy. So we are also contributing our bit to the US economy today. We are also a nation that is able to give as much as we take. There is $50 billion of investments, two-way investments. $20 billion is Indian investments in the United States. All of you are catalysts in that effort. You are people who can contribute to that effort in every way possible, whether it is, I'm not talking just about economic links, it's also social links, it's people-to-people contacts. In whichever fields you are all the top representatives of ours in every sector possible. We look to you for your advice, guidance, and help in our taking the relationship forward. I believe that we have come a long way, but we can also go a long way. There is considerable scope to take the relationship forward. There are some roadblocks along the way. We have to make sure that we avoid those pitfalls. We try and make the journey as smooth as possible. But I do believe the journey is one that can be a highly successful one. Someone told me just this afternoon that I thought the community was 20,000, but it's actually 120,000. The community
that
has
is in a metro Atlanta and 200,000 in entire Georgia.
So now you're saying 200,000. So we are also growing exponentially. I think that is a success to the community. We are bringing in the best, whether it's in terms of resources, in terms of human resources, in every way possible. And we are extremely proud of the contribution of our community all over the world. The Indian diaspora has been, a very, very untapped resource until Prime Minister Modi and the current government were able to look at the community as a huge positive reservoir of goodwill and support for India. Today, we've been able to harness the support of the Indian community all over the world, 25 to 30 million strong, for the flagship programs of the Government of India, be it Make in India, be it Smart Cities Program, be it Digital India, be it Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, or be it the Skill India Program. In every way, or the Gyan Program, which is very, very relevant because it brings professional expertise into India and the academic sector. The Indian community has contributed disproportionately to this effort. And in that effort, I think the community in the United States of America has been in the forefront. So I take this opportunity to thank you all. I'm delighted that our Consul General, very, very capable, able, and also a most affable Consul General. Not to forget our team of Mr. Sailesh Rastakya and the other consuls, other vice consuls, all of whom I've been, from what limited time that I've been here, I've seen, have been most efficient team, and they work together as a team. That also goes to the credit of the leader of the team. I think we are fortunate to have this representation in this part of the country, which we were never represented in before. So we certainly, as I said, look forward to keeping in contact with you at all levels, certainly also visiting some of the other states that are part of the southeastern United States and part of the consular jurisdiction of our consulate in Atlanta. Main aap sabhi ko bahut bahut dhanyawad dena chahunga aur aasha hai ki aapse phir mulaqat hogi Washington mein, Atlanta mein aur dusre United States ke dusre shaharon mein jagahon mein. Bahut bahut dhanyawad, and I hand it back now.
Consulate, and we have
have shown our beautiful building to ambassador and he said ours is the best. This is India House where we are just sitting. So it goes to say that how we have traveled so far. Thank you so much.
I just add one more point, if you permit, is that I did ask the Consul General to prepare a program, but I didn't realize that he prepared such an intense program. I've been out from 8 in the morning. And we've had some excellent interactions. I started with paying homage to Mahatma Gandhi at the Martin Luther King Memorial. Today is the 71st death anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. It's also coincides with the 150th birth anniversary. This year is the year in which we are celebrating this landmark event. It coincides with the 90th birth anniversary of Martin Luther King, the 60th anniversary of his visit to India. And in many senses, all of this comes together because Martin Luther King drew his inspiration from Mahatma Gandhi. And he in turn inspired so many other people. So, and all of that is in Atlanta and Georgia. And it was quite a moving experience for me to be there. In that very place where he lived and spread his message of peace and non-violence. After that, we went to call on Governor Kemp. We also went to the Senate and the House, both of which were very, very memorable experiences. The Atlanta Council on International Relations, at the instance of the Consul General, hosted us, and I was able to speak on India-US relations to the extent that I can, considering that I've been all of three weeks here. But it was also a very useful exercise for me. There were some very incisive questions, some of them from those of us who are here. Following that, we went across, had a press conference, some of our newspapers and magazines that cover community news were there. We also had some other newspapers like Bloomberg, other agencies who were there. After that, we went down to CNN, where I did an interview with CNN International. As you know, CNN is almost a household name. Ever since I can remember in India, for international news, we've been watching CNN. So coming to CNN headquarters in Atlanta was too good an opportunity to miss. Once again, I think we have to thank Swatiji because she is there. She was able to put it off at short notice. We also visited the consulate. As she has mentioned, it's a remarkably well-maintained, well-kept place. We are very proud to have a representation like that. We do believe that without being immodest, today India is not only a regional, upcoming nation, but also globally, we have to maintain our place in the diplomatic community, maintain our prestige, and at the same time, it must be a convenient place for many of you who come to seek services in the consulate. I was happy to see that since the consulate was established, we have issued about 160,000 visas, we have issued some 66,000 passports, we have issued some 55,000 OCI cards, and every day we issue 70 visas and about 60 passports. Well, that's quite a significant number. It must have made it convenient for many of you also to get these services close to you, within close proximity. And I think this is the essence and importance of what we do. We have to be of utility to those we serve. And in this case, those of you who are here the other interests that we are engage with in this part of the country. So I'm sorry that I have tried to hit the last word, Swati.
As the host,
you certainly do have the last word. I just wanted
you have summed it so nicely.
I know that that some of you were there at the lunch, but I thought I would share with everybody what we have done in Atlanta on this occasion. And it's been a full day. We don't believe in wasting time. Tomorrow at 5:30, I'm 5:30 in the morning leaving for Philadelphia, where I will take the first of the Chinook helicopters being delivered to us by Boeing Company will be accepted by me and the team from the Indian Air Force. And I think that's all. Thank you. A momentous occasion where we have become the largest repository of US military aircraft in the world, if I'm not mistaken, with a very wide range of aircraft of all types and categories.
No wonder the Boeing company is booming and it's stock
price. If you are in Lockheed Martin, you would say that you want some.
There is no such word called last word, because we want to welcome you all the time.
Yeah.
And we want you again, once you have the tour of all the consulate, again start with the Atlanta first.
She's setting you up again.
As mentioned, there is no last word, but we can have the biggest round of applause for Sir.
Yes.
That further, we just met some of our officials who are here to look at a project of purchase of helicopters in this part of the country. So we're very happy to see that this is a very vibrant part of the United States, and we have good business ties.
Your trip about Philadelphia tomorrow?
Well, let me tell you that I've had a very full day in Atlanta itself. We started with paying homage to Mahatma Gandhi. This is his 71st death anniversary. This was the Martin Luther King Center where his statue is located. And it was a great honor to be able to also pay tribute to the memory of another great leader who has been inspired by Mahatma Gandhi's ideas and teachings. And after that, we went to the Senate, the Golden Dome, where I met Governor Kim, also newly established in office. We exchanged some good notes, particularly, I think Consul General Swati wanted to emphasize to him that he should plan a visit to India as early as possible, that the state of Georgia should establish a commercial office in India, that we should look at some transport linkages in the aviation side with between Atlanta and city in India. So it was a very productive meeting. I met the Lieutenant Governor. I went to both the Senate and the House, met the representatives, met a number of senators, very productive meetings. We also had an interaction with media in Atlanta. There were a number of news outlets, including Bloomberg and some of those from representing the Indian community. In the afternoon, we went to CNN. It was, CNN is a household name in India. It was good to do an interview with them and see the CNN headquarters that Ted Turner established. I visited the Indian consulate. It was a very proud moment to see a wonderful building. A very, very efficient team working under the able leadership of our consul general. And I think clearly we are in very good hands here. And of course, the crowning part of the day was the evening reception, where I met the select representatives of the Indian community, a very dynamic, vibrant community. We met people from very, very different disciplines and walks of life. The one common thing between all of them was that they are all successful. They are all people who have contributed greatly to the societies and economies in which they live. And I have conveyed to the community that we consider that not only that they are a great resource for us, but this is a community that can help strengthen ties between our two countries. They are the bridge between our countries. And they have been doing that, and we will look to them and their support to further extend their activities so that they can support what we are trying to do in the United States. Our overall diplomatic efforts can be strengthened greatly by the community. This is something that our consul general is already leveraging, and we hope to do it all the time.
And what would be the one thing you would take back from Atlanta to Washington?
Well, I'm not going to say the Super Bowl fever. We've seen a lot of that, but clearly this is a very vibrant city. You can see the dynamism of the city. It is headquarters to half of the Fortune 500 companies. A lot of the names of companies that are headquartered here are very well known to us, right? Coca-Cola, to Home Depot, to UPS, and you name it, you go down the list. It's clearly, as I said, an industrial communications transportation hub, and one that we would be very well advised to engage with more actively in the future.
And what is India's point of view on strengthening the USA-India ties altogether, or their vision of growth?
There's a long answer to that short question. But essentially, I think we've come a long way. In the last decade or so, we have made enormous progress in our relationship. Today, the United States is a partner, interlocutor, a country with whom we work closely together, not only on strengthening bilateral relations, but also on regional and global issues of mutual interest. And we hope that we can work with the United States to take that relationship both quantitatively and qualitatively forward over the next few years.
Thank you very much, sir.